Very excited to be here today and to receive such a warm welcome, especially because this is actually the first outing that we've had from the ministry for a very, very long time. So I appreciate the warm welcome that's been given to me and my staff. This morning, ladies and gentlemen, we're not just here to do a handover, but we're here to actually celebrate your achievements, as mentioned by the speaker before me. We're here to celebrate your achievements as a community. And as a representative of your government, I want to say we are glad to be able to contribute to your community. We will continue to support and empower Fijians to earn a sustainable living. And this is one of the critical components of the recovery of the economy. And that's exactly what Fiji needs right now. Ladies and gentlemen, the Integrated Human Resources Development Program, or the IHRDP, as you all know it, has worked with the Navutulevu Development Enterprise so communities can pool their resources and work together on projects that generate income and create decent work. Through this particular program, or through this very program, we have supported about 26 communities over the last 5 years. And if we were to put a money value onto it, we are looking at about $1.8 million.
Okay.
But apart from the finance, we actually also take pride in knowing that we've impacted the livelihoods of people, which is something that we cannot measure. The project cost of this portable sawmill, the carpentry tools and the small machines that we're actually handing over today is valued at
$73,675.
The Navutulevu Development Enterprise contributed more than $18,000, and whilst the Fijian government supported the balance of approximately $55,000 through grant funding. What's important is when the community contributes towards a project, there is ownership. There is ownership and there is increased responsibility. Responsibility to achieve the desired results and basically to have the project work. And that's one of the most important things. The handover of the equipment and resources today is a hallmark of many good things to come. And these assets have to be used in the right way and looked after very well. And for you to realize your investments, you've been in this business for a long time, and I think you know that very well. I want to tell you all, I want to reiterate that this is your project. And you need to take full ownership of the business to ensure that the business continues to grow and flourish for you, for your families, and for your community. This can only be achieved if you run the enterprise with good business principles and integrity. And I think you've got a lot of people here, as you say, out of school and degree holders, etc., who are willing to help and are part of the program. If you do this business, you'll be able to create better lives for you and your family, as you all know. You'll be able to send your kids to school and to university, and to put food on the table, and to attend to most other financial commitments that you may have. And most importantly, I think what's really important, it actually strengthens the community. And the community will work together as a united group to contribute to the growth of the country. It's encouraging also for us to see the youth involvement in the Navutulevu Development Enterprise. I understand that there's about 50-odd youth in the area that are trained and actually certified by the Ministry of Forestry, and they have a chainsaw operator license and a portable sawmill operator licenses. And these youth have identified a viable career in the forestry sector. And they are our future and our agents for change. And just a couple of days ago, I spoke to the former Minister for Forests, he was very happy to hear that we were actually coming here to do this. And he passed on his congratulations. This business, and as you all know, he's a very learned man in the industry, so he had some very nice words to say about your project here. This business will allow you and the youth and the resource owners to utilize your resources and your forests. And I urge the community to actually think big for the future and to convert the resources into income, exactly what you've spoken about. And it's equally important that you establish sustainable practices and to ensure that the trees that you benefit from today are there tomorrow for your children and your grandchildren, etc. You must do this in a sustainable fashion for Fiji's sake. You've been hearing that we need to change the way also that business is done. And I want to say thank you also to all of you for doing this today and adhering to all the necessary COVID protocols whilst we're actually doing this. You know, there's a new way of doing business, there's a new way of doing everything now because of COVID. And all business practices need to follow the COVID safe practices, and I take my hat off to you and in doing that today. Thank you very much. That has allowed us to be here and sit here and take part in this today. It simply means that you continue to wear masks and maintain a distance of 2 meters, practice sanitization, and always wash your hands, etc. You know, one of the most important things that we must remember, I had a meeting yesterday with our CRM team, is that just because the borders are opening locally and internationally does not mean that we stop wearing masks and we stop sanitizing. You must continue to do that for our own safety. You must continue to do that because it can very easily lead to us turning it around and saying curfews are back on and we're in lockdown, and that is not what we want. So please ensure that we continue to adhere to the COVID safe practices, because we really want to open up our tourism industry, which has an impact on Fiji and some of you also who may be part of the industry, so that all Fijians can actually go back to work. One of the aims of government is all Fijians working together is the only driving force that will help us overcome the impacts of COVID-19 and take Fiji and our economy forward. It also means that we'll open opportunities that you too, and you will allow you to secure international markets more freely and also allow you to secure a bit more customers. I want to urge the Navutulevu Development Enterprise to take advantage also of our Fijian Made by Fijian campaign. Our Fijian brand is well recognized around the world. And what you make locally can someday reach an overseas market. And the ministry is really willing and able to help you to facilitate this. Like any other business, you will also face some challenges along the way, but we will continue to support you in the best way that we can. I'd like to acknowledge some of the other government ministries also that have assisted, and the private sector partners who have worked with the IHRDP to make this happen today. Now, before I conclude again, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to remind you all that such opportunities were not given to those that were before you, but now you are in a position to create opportunities for those that come after you. So that is a fantastic opportunity for all the future of our children. So please use it well. So with those few words, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to now attend to the